Welcome to our simple guide on how to build a model boat. There are lots of different boat kits available. We've chosen the Lesero Arrow, which is a simple 1960s powerboat construction. It's built from bolts of wood and ply, and the kit's available from Lesero Models Direct of Christchurch. But there are lots of similar models you can purchase. Have a good look on the internet and buy yourself a copy of Model Boats magazine from W.H. Smith's for inspiration. Choose your model carefully and do some research. Companies like Lesero Models have been in existence for a long time, and therefore you can be guaranteed a quality product, but there are plenty of cheap imports where the model simply hasn't been sought through. In addition to the actual boat kit, you're likely to need radio control gear, a simple motor, a prop shaft, and propeller so that you can actually drive the boat. You should also purchase a rudder, and you'll need a battery pack and a charger. Another important piece of kit will be an electronic speed controller that actually drives the boat forward. These can be quite tricky to pick, so it's best to talk to somebody with modelling experience before you choose one. As you can see, I've already started the construction of this boat, having laid out the plans on the dining room table. You can see that it's very simple to assemble. Side pieces and ribs form the main structure of the boat. The plans are to scale, and therefore you can simply lay the wooden pieces on top of the plan. And also, you can see I've templated in pencil all the parts on the back of the plan, so I can make as many future copies of the boat as I like for no extra money. More and more of the pieces now have been stuck. It's just standard wood glue, although you can purchase better quality tight bond brand wood glues. You also don't really need any specialist tools, but you will need sandpaper and at least one simple sharp knife to help you with the construction, but balsa wood's very easy to cut. A hacksaw and a drill is going to help you as well during the construction. Now, you might think that applying and shaping the flat pieces of plywood that form the sides of the boat, which is known as skinning the boat, to form the hull, is very difficult, but in fact it's just a matter of holding them against the side of the boat and running round with a pencil before cutting them out, and then reapplying them with clips and gluing them to get the correct shape. As you can see then, the top skin of the boat, the deck, is again formed from flat pieces of thin plywood, which are just faced on top of the boat. The rails across the bottom of the boat give it stability in the water while moving forward. Very simple to apply, just glue them on following pencil lines. It's then time to get your sandpaper out and give the whole hull a good smoothing over before application of some gloss paint to seal it. It's also a good idea to seal the inside of the hull at this point just with some varnish to give the boat many years of life. You can see that I've also smoothed around the exit point of the prop shaft with some filler. The filler adds strength to the exit point of the prop shaft and gives it a more boat-like look. I've now fitted a nice brass prop and rudder to complete the boat, and you can see that what's called a skeg has been fitted underneath that gives added support to the prop shaft. And the boat's now starting to come together very nicely. We've applied a blue and white colour scheme, and you can see that the canopy that replicates the windscreen is simply flexible ply. Under the front hatch is the electric motor, now fitted with a simple cooling coil which will use silicon tubes to pick up water from underneath the boat from a simple scoop around the motor and out the side of the boat. I've also now test fitted the battery to make sure that there's plenty of room, and this is the boat nearly finished with the final deck applied. With the gloss paint nice and set, it's just time to add some finishing touches with stickers and trim line tape, which nicely highlights the contrast between the blue and white paintwork. The small flags are available from most hobby shops, so it's simply time now to make a very simple cradle for the boat, which will prevent damage. You can add some final deck fittings. Often white metal fittings are the easiest to purchase. Simply glue them to the boat with some good quality 2-pack resin. With the boat completed, it's off to the lake to see how she handles. And what a great feeling it is to know that you've taken a box of wood and produced a beautiful working model boat from it. So why not join us at Buxton Model Boat Club? There's no excuse. See us at www.buxtonmodelboatclub.co.uk. Hope to see you there.